I'm Conrad Monti, and I'm filling in for the esteemed Roger Martin, host of Out and About with Roger Martin. And Roger's on assignment, or that's what they say. He might be drunk, who knows. But anyway, we're at the Military Collectibles Show at the Fairplex in Pomona. And I'm here to tell you, it is a wonderful show. I mean, there are collectibles from every military history, going back to the Revolutionary War up until today. It is an amazing display of memorabilia, one I have never seen quite like it here in Southern California. Fairplex in Pomona, California is ground zero for the Western Militaria Show, the West's largest trade show dedicated to military collectibles and memorabilia.
You know what? We've been running this show. It's the West Coast Historical Military Collectors Show. We've been running for about 15 years here. Started off as my childhood, going to shows every weekend, and now we do it once a year here in Pomona. We're the largest military collectible show on the West Coast.
Well, it's a wonderful show. I've never seen so much memorabilia under one roof. It's just great. What is the most important thing about this to you?
You know, to me, doing the military collectibles is the history. You know, the standing out what the veterans did and everything, and then the history of each piece in here, the photographs, the patch, the uniform, it all says and tells you about history and what the U.S. serviceman has done for this country.
Table after table is laden with the spoils of war. Everything from helmets to basic survival gear, as well as all manner of uniforms. There are a variety of military threads, as well as actual military thread for those experiencing wardrobe malfunction of the khaki kind. And among those proud enough to wear the uniform is a man emulating none other than the great Douglas MacArthur. Well, this is a pleasure running into General MacArthur here today. I'd like to ask him, what's going on?
Well, I'm having a wonderful time at the show today. This is my first time. I missed it last year. And I'm impressed with all the items here and all the displays as well. I think it's a good way to make history alive for new generations who can actually touch, smell, and feel all these items here. Absolutely wonderful.
Well, I agree. I think it's just an overwhelming show. It's so wonderful. Are you the general's aide or aide-de-camp, or what's your position here?
I'm his protection.
Oh, so this is the general's bodyguard here, and, a big man like this probably needs ones, though.
Oh, I think he needs more than just one man.
You think?
But I can handle it. Bring all the pressure.
Well, you look like you're man enough to do it.
Thank you.
Stick your guns there. Thank you for showing up, General. Vehicles of war are a big draw to shows like this, and there was no shortage of them here. On display is the massive six-wheel drive Pinscower high-mobility all-terrain vehicle, as well as a Jeep. This one, courtesy of a military museum in the city of El Monte, California.
Well, I'm a volunteer at the American Military Museum, and we're based in South El Monte in the Whittier Narrows Recreation Area. And we have a number of displays, military vehicles there. We restore them. We're at the show today to raise money for the museum so we can preserve some of the history that they have there.
Sounds good. When is the museum open?
The museum's open Fridays, Saturdays, and Sundays, 10 a.m. to 4:30 p.m. And it's also open for special events, but basically Friday, Saturdays, and Sundays.
Well, it sounds great. Could you tell us some of the vehicles you have there?
Well, we have a number of the patent tanks from the M60, M47, M48. number of Shermans. We also have a gun tub that was has a quad 40s from the battleship Missouri, which is a very rare thing. It was taken off the Missouri when they retrofitted it in the 50s.
Well, it sounds like a wonderful place to spend the day just for the memorabilia fiend or buff who loves these collectible things, which I do.
Oh, absolutely. My son and me, we've been volunteering there for going on 4 years now, and he's a history major, and that's what he wants to do. And I'm a kind of a closet history buff myself, so we really enjoy working there.
Well, it sounds like it's well worth a trip out to the American Military Museum in South El Monte. Thanks again, Joe.
Well, thank you, and I hope we get a lot of people out there to see us.
One notable attendee to the show included the son of Henry Cano, a hero of the 442nd Infantry Regiment, the famed fighting unit that was ironically composed almost entirely of Japanese-American soldiers.
He was here in California until July of 42, and when he finished his training, they sent him to back east to help train the 442.
So they went from California to where, Camp Shelby, Mississippi? What rank did Henry finally achieve?
Sergeant.
Sergeant.
Yes.
In the 442nd.
Yes.
Was he in their those vicious campaigns in Italy and in the Vosges area of France?
Well, he was here in the States for 3 years, training people on machine guns and building machine gun ranges. And he used to go back east to visit my mother every chance he had. And in 44, late 44, the trains were late. So he got back to camp a few hours late, and they busted him to private and sent him overseas. So he got overseas somewhere around November of 44. And that's when he went into combat with the 442. He was in the 100th Battalion.
In its history, the 442nd Regiment was awarded 8 Presidential Unit Citations, and many of its members were awarded the Medal of Honor for World War II. Henry Cano was honored with an action figure in his likeness, and it is displayed at the table among other items and memorabilia made famous by this highly decorated regiment.
Well, on the first half of the table here, I've got my father's artifacts, some things that his personal effects, and there's a 1/6 doll there too of him that was made just a couple years ago. I've got copies of a lot of his history because I've done a lot of research on him through the years as I was growing up. So the first part of the table is devoted to him. The middle part of the table is devoted to my organization, the California Historical Group. And we're a reenactment group. We do World War II. We like to go out in the field and we reenact battles. And that's a private thing. That's what we like to do. I have the Jeep at the other end, and that we use at reenactments as well. And then at the end of the table, I actually have actual artifacts, some samples of soils from different battlefields and different wartime locations. And that's pretty much what I have here, and a few weapons displays.
There was more Medal of Honors issued to that unit than any other unit ever. And you know, if I have to say it, my favorite military war movie is Go for Broke, which is a story about them. So it's hard to go wrong with that.
Why is this only a 2-day show?
The dealers travel from all over the country and all over the world to come in here. By the time they do Sunday, it's hard to keep them here. And plus in LA, we have so many antique memorabilia shows on the Sundays that we can't get them to come to the show. Like tomorrow, everybody will be at Rose Bowl shopping at the antique markets.
With all of the historic uniforms on display, it would be a shame not to see a few men in uniform proudly displaying them. The uniform contest is among the most highly anticipated events of this show.
What we do with this, it's kind of a holdover. If you remember when the Great Western Gun Show was here back
years ago.
I grew up going to those shows and being here. In fact, my first booth was in this building. And, you know, it was one of those things I always enjoyed watching when they did the costume contest. So when we brought the show back here, I said, you know what, let's do the costume contest again. Hopefully you guys will be there to see it, because when you see it, you'll see some of the greatest uniforms and guys who have just gone through so much research and so much history to make sure their uniforms are just right, and it shows.
The uniformed contingent includes nearly 2 dozen men and 1 woman, proudly representing their nation's best. The time span includes World War I doughboys in authentic military uniforms, to participants decked out in World War II sailor uniforms. This one, a recreation of one worn by his grandfather. The sole female participant proudly represents the 442nd Infantry Regiment. The U.S. Cavalry is honored by this participant, who displays a uniform from 1942. The variety of participants and the uniforms they display are a fitting tribute to the men and women who proudly wear the uniform in the service of their country.
You know, this is the only military-only show this size that's held in California. In fact, it's the only military-only show this size held west of the Mississippi. We have a couple small military shows that happen in Southern California. Once a month, there's one in Bellflower. But for most of us, sad to say, we're all a bunch of like gypsies, because we'll all go to the next show and the next show around the world. I mean, I do shows in Tokyo, I do shows in Europe, everything.